the top stories. Chief Medical Officer says vaccine has high efficacy after 4 weeks. Attorney General responds to recent SCASPA announcement on use of facilities. And bus drivers express concern over new limited capacity. The details on these stories and more after the break.
Without limits, happy and free. The skin you're in with no apology. The one to seize the day. Grab an LLB. Live, love, be. Angostura, lemon, lime, and bitters. Live, love, be.
Trustworthy. Secure. Reliable and responsive. These are just some of the words customers use to describe their experience with the Bank of Nevis Limited. And after 35 years of delivering excellent customer service and honoring our corporate social responsibilities in the island of Nevis, we are finally in St. Kitts. Come and experience why we're not just another option. We are the standard. Bond Strong.
Look at you, no braces, all the internet you can handle.
I wasn't so lucky.
Invis is not your parents' braces. Invis is predictable, less painful, more comfortable. Invisalign.
Visit Dr. Blake's General Dentistry and Orthodontics located on South Independence Square Street for your free Invisalign consultation. Call 466-7622 for your appointments.
Are you looking for today's best architectural designs, appraisals, estimates, or even project management? Then look no further than Trevor Freights and Associates. Our designs are amazing. You'll be so satisfied with your work, you will tell others all about us. Visit TrevorFreights.com today, located at New Road on St. Kitts. With over 20 years in the industry, we strive to provide the utmost superior quality of service to all our valued customers. Call our expert staff at 465-8184 or 662-5184 and see what we can do for you. That's Trevor, FRAITES.com. You decide, we design.
Hello and welcome to the ZIZ Channel 5 newscast. I'm Kyla Berridge. Medical Chief of Staff at the Joseph N. France General Hospital, Dr. Cameron Wilkinson, assured that the efficacy of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine will remain high even with a reduced time frame between the first and second jabs. On Tuesday's edition of Leadership Matters, Dr. Wilkinson commended persons who continue to come forward to receive the COVID-19 vaccine. He said that science has demonstrated that the first dose of the vaccine provides a 76% efficacy. A dosing interval between 4 to 12 weeks increases the efficacy above 82%, he added.
Ideally, if you gave the vaccine between 10 to 12 weeks, the efficacy should be greatest. But the manufacturers recommend that it can be given anywhere out of 4 weeks. And because of the situation that we're in right now, where some persons were hesitant, we have to use the vaccine that we have available, we have shortened the time between the doses, but the efficacy should be still significant because, as I said, all of the recommended is between 8 to 12 weeks. It can be given based on the manufacturers after 4 weeks.
Health authorities have reduced the time between the first and second doses in order to maximize the vaccine usage, which continues to set daily records. Dr. Wilkinson told ZIZ that the vaccine already provides coverage from the first dose, and the second dose provides even more coverage, even as early as 4 weeks afterwards.
The minimum interval between the first and the second dose is 28 days or 4 weeks. The dosing interval that is recommended by the manufacturer is anywhere from 4 to 12 weeks, and the World Health Organization recommends 8 to 12 weeks. The efficacy of the first dose is 76%, which means that when someone receives one dose, they have 76% protection. The efficacy after the second dose rises to about 82.4%. Studies have shown that the longer the dosing interval, it's associated with the higher efficacy. And the highest efficacy is seen when it's given 10 to 12 weeks after the first dose.
Tuesday's records revealed that 725 persons received the first jab, while 337 got their second dose. Chief Medical Officer Dr. Hazel Laws said that persons taking the vaccine this week will receive their second dose in about 4.5 to 5 weeks. Minister responsible for legal affairs, Honorable Vincent Byron, says Cabinet has not given the green light on a recent statement issued by the St. Kitts Air and Seaport Authority, SCASPA. She made the statement at Wednesday's NEOC COVID-19 briefing after the release was circulated that afternoon.
This document was brought to the attention of the government, and I would say that it had been inadvertently published. At this point in time, the cabinet has given no such consideration or decision. And so we would want to say that until such time as the cabinet has issued or supported such a decision, we would hope that this document would be disregarded at this time. Thank you.
During the afternoon, a statement was received stating, quote, the St. Christopher Air and Seaport Authority, SCASPA, wishes to advise the public that effective June 1st, 2021, all persons wishing to conduct business at the port's facilities, both air and sea, must present proof of COVID-19 vaccination or a valid negative RT-PCR test taken within the past 14 days. This decision has become necessary to prevent the transmission of the virus to the employees and stakeholders conducting business within SCASPA space, end quote. ZIZ will continue to follow this story as it develops and will have more information as it becomes available. Local bus driver associations are voicing their concerns over recent decisions taken to curb the spread of COVID-19. More in this report.
Following the announcement of more than a dozen new positive COVID-19 cases this month, the government implemented new regulations to restrict the spread of the disease. As part of those measures, for 2 weeks, passenger buses are being limited in the number of persons they can carry, as explained by Divisional Commander of District A, Superintendent Cromwell Henry.
Because this virus is spread by close contact with other persons, and because we've had evidence of persons who were positive traveling on public service vehicle, the CMO in her wisdom thought it best to restrict the number of persons who are traveling on public service vehicle so that you may have a little more space between persons. And so public service vehicles are only permitted now during this period to carry half of their regular capacity.
However, this restriction isn't sitting well with the bus drivers themselves. Nicholson Webster, the president of the Westline Bus Association, said he's disappointed that there was no consultation with the bus drivers before the decision was taken.
We have different buses carry different amount of people, so it's not a one-size-fits-all situation. We even have new buses that carry less than 14 people. So when you say 7 people in a bus, it's an issue. If they had sit down and speak with the president, we could have better informed them and agreed to move forward on a better and a better decision. What we can do, we can have two people in the seat on the far left and on the far right, Poro, and one in the front.
Bus driver Rodney Batiste said the reduced capacity is having a significant impact on their earnings.
Schools are on lockdown for 2 weeks, which means that we have less people to transport. And it is not easy paying for these buses. Some of us have almost $2,000 to meet the bank at the end of the month. A lot of people have mortgages on that. You have your family to feed. You have all sorts of bills to pay. So it's not easy. And the reduced capacity has been a major impact, a significant impact on our daily earnings.
He suggested that the government can offer some sort of financial assistance during this two-week period.
A special subsidy can be given to the bus operators to cover that two-week period where schools are on lockdown, which means that we have less people to transport. And if they give a special subsidy towards that, I believe that that would go a long way towards assisting the bus drivers, the bus operators.
Mr. Batiste said the reduced capacity is only aggravating a situation where bus fees are already very low, in his opinion, and he feels that after 13 years without a bus fare increase, there may be need to talk about reviewing the prices for each destination. But that's a conversation for another time. Jason Davis for ZIZ News.
After the break, man charged for robbery and parents asked to support the government's vaccination efforts. Stay with us.
There is no better time to discover what your National Bank Visa debit or black cards can do.
Mimi, what's that song?
It can get you out of a pickle. Using my National Bank Visa card is fast, secure, and convenient.
Cashless Eska N is our new lifestyle choice. National Bank, always here.
Here are your Horsford's Value Mart IGA Value Club Blue Tag Specials for May 28th through June 2nd. IGA Peanut Butter Premium or Crunchy, $7.99. Essential Everyday Lasagna, $4.49. Essential Everyday Pasta Sauces, $6.99. General Mills Cereals, $15.99 each. IGA Salad Dressings, $5.99 each. Almond Breeze Milk, $12.99. And now, our very low weekly value deals. Planters Dry Roasted Peanuts or Lightly Salted, $11.99. Cream of Wheat, Large, $11.99. Almond Hammer Detergent, just $13.99. 20-ounce Gatorade, $2.99. Yoplait yogurt, $3.39. IGA Honey Bears, $12.99 each. Shop smart, shop Value Mart. Sea listo y haga sus compras aquí a Value Mart.
Flow Broadband and TV is packed with even more value as you get a free Samsung tablet, free installation, and 50% off your bill for 3 months when you sign up now. Yes, a free Samsung tablet. Power all you do at home with up to 100 megabits per second super fast broadband. Plus, stay HD entertained with Flow TV. Stream, share, and do more on your new free tablet, which will also keep you connected on the go with ease. Sign up at a Flow store today.
Conditions apply.
The St. Kitts and Nevis Chamber of Industry and Commerce would like to remind persons when patronizing businesses to abide by the following COVID-19 guidelines to protect employees, customers, and our community. Urge employers to check employees and customers with a non-contact head thermometer on arrival to a business place. It's mandatory that employees wear a face mask when at work and in the presence of others. No customers will be permitted to enter an establishment without a face mask. Encourage both employees and customers to wash their hands with soap and water or sanitize their hands with an alcohol-based hand sanitizer of at least 60% alcohol when entering a building, after interacting with customers, and throughout the day. Remember to maintain 6 feet physical and social distancing. Consider installing barriers such as sneeze guards or partitions in high traffic areas to limit close contact between employees and customers. Clean and disinfect highly touched surfaces such as doorknobs, telephones, cash registers.
Efforts to return schools to normalcy. During Tuesday's edition of Leadership Matters, Mr. Hodge said the pandemic is making a huge impact on the schools.
Learning is disrupted, just on the brink of examinations. Schools are forced to abandon their field trips and educational tours. Graduations may not be held except virtually. Parents are forced to remain at home to provide care for their children. Some parents may actually lose their jobs. COVID-19 is in our schools. Teachers, students, ancillary staff are contracting the virus. Some are in quarantine.
He said it is necessary that parents get vaccinated in an effort to stop the spread of the virus.
We as adults, parents, teachers, must leverage the resources at our disposal to stop the spread of this deadly virus. Let me be straightforward here. Parents and teachers must be vaccinated. We have a moral and God-given responsibility to protect the children that God has given to us.
The Ministry of Education has continued its vaccination education program to educate parents and teachers about the importance and benefits of vaccination. And finally, on the local scene, to show solidarity with the Roll Up to Roll Out vaccination campaign, media personalities of ZIZ Broadcasting Corporation have now gotten both doses of the vaccine. This week, newsroom manager Jason Davis and broadcast services manager Cheryl Ward gave their second dose of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine at separate health centers. Mr. Davis said he is doing his part in the fight against COVID-19, while at the same time assisting in efforts to return the country to normalcy. Over the next 2 weeks, vaccinations are being done at all of the health centers during extended hours from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. on weekdays and from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. on Saturdays. Coming up in regional news, Antigua to test for COVID variants. The details when we come back.
Everything's gotta go. Horseroads Automotive, everything gotta go. Clearance sale is happening now. All 2018, 2019, and 2020 models gotta go. Yes. Come to Horseroads Automotive and get $10,000 off select 2020 models. That's right. Horseroads Automotive is making room for 2021 by offering $10,000 off select 2020 models. And that's not all. Come now and get 0% down payment. No payment until May 2021. $500 in free groceries, free servicing for 1 year, free bill of sale, free tinting, free registration, free accessories, and free licensing. Horseroads Automotive, everything gotta go clearance sale. The biggest clearance sale event of the year. Select 2020 vehicles, price to go. Everything gotta go.
Terms and conditions apply. See store for details.
This
This month, make it all about her with a gift from Courts. Shop today and enjoy up to 30% off selected rugs, accessories, and more. Get the most stylish appliances, home furnishings, and more. Plus, shop today with Ready Finance and we'll pay your first and last installment. You can also shop online at www.shopcourts.com for the same great savings. So make it all about her with something special from Courts. Courts, bringing value home.
And we're moving now to news on the regional scene. Antigua and Barbuda will soon be testing for three COVID-19 variants of concern, the Kent UK, South African and Brazilian variants. That announcement was made by Dr. Lester Simon, head of the laboratory at the St. John's Medical Center. ABS's Jamie Roche has more.
Dr. Lester Simon says his team will begin variant testing in 1 to 3 weeks. He says the Pan American Health Organization provides variant reagents for Antigua and Barbuda and other PAHO member countries.
Because it's a composite set of reagents that we're using to test for the variants, we won't be able to say whether it's one or the other. Okay. We'll just know that it's one of the three variants.
Dr. Simon says if a positive sample is identified as one of the variants, they will send a sample to CAFA to determine which variant triggered the result. A viral variant forms when a virus mutates while making copies of itself. Scientists are working to determine more about variants with concerning mutations. They're interested in how easily they spread, whether they cause more severe illness, and whether currently authorized vaccines will protect people against them. Researchers recently identified a new variant of concern in India. Dr. Simon says his team would be able to start testing for that variant once they get its reagent. Jamie J. Roche, ABS News.
Education officials in St. Lucia are in discussions to increase safety and security as attacks on secondary school students have increased in recent weeks. HTS News has more.
Is your child safe on their way to and from school? A recent spate of attacks and robberies on secondary school students of the Leon Hess Comprehensive Secondary School elicited a high-level multi-sectorial meeting of stakeholders to discuss and strategize a way to safeguard students from becoming victims of random attacks.
Our main focus will be traffic patrol. We have also identified as to what means that we're going to take in patrolling that area.
Acting Inspector of Police Calixtus Shalmine detailed the difficulties with limited resources while attempting to ramp up patrols.
Sustaining that can be a challenge for our department because we are stretched as present, and with the COVID situation, the shift rotation normally puts a strain on the department. We'll do our best to manage that situation at Marshall area.
The president of the National Council on Public Transportation, Godfrey Ferdinand, highlighted the need for the immediate implementation of some of the strategies.
For all the different stakeholders to come together, formulate a plan, and that plan would be to increase security, as well as having the students take the buses instead of walking. And if it requires that the principals and the teachers at least have what you call a PTA meeting to instruct the parents to have their children wait at the school, that would be a better format for us, or should I say solution, because most of these things happen all along the route, not necessarily on the bus stop.
Chief Education Officer Dr. Fiona Philip Meyer offered her expectations of the results coming out of the engagement with transport and law enforcement officials.
We met with the police, very fruitful meeting, out of which came quite strategic plans to support our students and their well-being. Today we're meeting with the transport services, as well as the police are represented. We have our chief transport officer with us. Principals are there as well, because we want to make sure that everybody works together for the good, not only of our students, for the wider community.
The high-level meeting provided an opportunity for officials to plan logistics and thrash out ideas on how best to address the attacks on the students of District 3. Solange Alfred, HTS News Force.
Coming up, a crisis escalates across Asia Pacific. We'll tell you more when we come back.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy a life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve, we protect, we satisfy. That's NCI.
It's time to scratch and match with Digicel. Collect scratch cards when you top up $20 or more at any Digicel reseller or store, or pay your phone or home and internet bill in full. Scratch and match. Get two or more of the same digital app and you win a prize. It's that simple. Win cash, credit, vouchers, lunches, spa dates, Digicel merchandise, and more. Plus, take the top half of your scratch cards to any of our retail stores to qualify for even more prizes in the big draw. Stay tuned to our social media pages to find out how to double or even triple your chances to scratch and match. Top up or pay your bill today. Get scratching, get matching. Digicel, better together.
Welcome back. Authorities in Australia's second most populous state of Victoria have imposed a one-week lockdown to contain a COVID-19 outbreak detected earlier this week. Elsewhere in the region, Taiwan reported 667 new domestic COVID-19 cases on Thursday, a day after it tightened curbs to contain the rise in infections. Malaysia, which now has more cases per capita than India, is struggling to contain the virus. Al Jazeera's Florence Louis reports from Kuala Lumpur.
Jimmy Chang has been home on unpaid leave since Taiwan's government tightened its pandemic restrictions last week. The gym he manages will be shut until mid-June at the earliest.
It worries me a lot. If the situation gets worse, my income will be affected. I may not be able to support my family.
Until this month, the island had been reporting single-digit cases. It reported around 670 infections on Thursday. Malaysia is also battling a surge. There's been a five-fold increase here since the start of the year. This week, it recorded an average of 60 deaths a day since Monday. Its health services are under strain, and the Director General has warned the country must prepare for the worst. The government has tightened restrictions by, among other things, banning domestic travel and social activities.
But it has resisted a full lockdown, citing fears of an economic disaster. The government has instead urged Malaysians to go on a self-imposed lockdown and stay home as much as possible.
In Australia's southern state of Victoria, people will have to remain home except for essential business. A new cluster of infections was detected in Melbourne this week, and cases are expected to rise in the coming days. Many countries in the region appeared to have the virus under control last year, but they've fallen behind on vaccination.
You know, vaccination is the only way to lead us out of this pandemic. Unfortunately, the supply of vaccines in the whole Asia is disproportionately low because it will take 1 or 2 years for the whole region to reach the herd immunity.
The pace of inoculation is slowly picking up. Japan, set to host the Summer Olympics in July during a worsening COVID-19 crisis, is ramping up its vaccination campaign. Vietnam, once a success story but now battling its largest outbreak of the virus, has set up a special fund to drive its vaccination program. Florence Louis, Al Jazeera, Kuala Lumpur.
A Southwest Airlines flight attendant had her cheek knocked out by a passenger in an attack captured on camera. Video shows the passenger repeatedly punching the attendant on a flight from Sacramento to San Diego.
It's the sickening moment a female passenger repeatedly punches a flight attendant. Another passenger steps in to come to her aid.
Don't you dare touch a flight attendant like this.
Moments later, the flight attendant is seen with blood pouring down her battered face. She lost two teeth in the shocking attack. It happened on a Southwest Airlines flight from Sacramento to San Diego. Witnesses say it started after the passenger took off her seatbelt after landing. The flight attendant told her to keep it on while taxiing, an instruction you hear on every flight in the world.
She stood up and just punched her in the face.
So you saw the passenger hit the flight attendant?
Oh yeah, I mean, she hit her so hard.
This passenger shot the dramatic video.
It's just sad to me that America is so frustrated right now. People don't want to be told what to do.
It's not the friendly skies anymore. Assaults on flight attendants are skyrocketing. They say they've been pushed, punched, slapped, even choked by unruly passengers. Now authorities fear there may be even more violence in the skies this Memorial Day weekend. The FAA usually handles 150 incidents of unruly passengers in a year. So far this year, there have been 2,500 cases, and it's only May.
The hostility that passengers are showing right now is unprecedented, and it becomes a challenge for flight attendants just on a day-to-day basis. They're being called names, they're being challenged, they're just facing situations that we've never had to face before.
Police say the woman who punched the flight attendant is 28-year-old Viviana Quinones. A fellow passenger posted, "Lady, welcome to the no-fly list."
If you misbehave on board an aircraft, you should be banned from flying on that airline for life.
Viviana Quinones was arrested on suspicion of battery causing serious injury. She claims she acted in self-defense.
Up next in sports, World Cup qualifier matches permitted to play in St. Kitts and Nevis. And Trinidadians show interest in track cycling. Stay with us.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy a life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve, we protect, we satisfy. That's NCI.
I took the vaccine because I want the in-person audience experience at Sugar Mass 50.
I took the vaccine because I want to be performing with all my peoples on Ultra Truck this year for Carnival.
I get vaccinated because I want to be on the road for Sugar Mass 50.
The reason I chose to be vaccinated is because of my profession as an entertainer, was to have a safer Boyter Carnival.
I am DJ Flames, and I got vaccinated because I want Sugar Mass 50 to be greater than ever.
I took the vaccine because I miss entertaining thousands of people, and I miss hosting my own events. See you at Sugar Mass 50. Boom.
Get vaccinated quickly to turn up Sugar Mass 50.
First up in sports, a section of the recently announced statutory rules and orders has restricted contact sports such as football. However, an exception has been made for World Cup qualifier matches in June. That's according to Divisional Commander for District A, Superintendent Cromwell Henry, during ZIZ Radio's program Policing With You on Thursday. He said an agreement was made between the government of St. Kitts and Nevis and the football associations of Guyana and Puerto Rico to host these matches before the most recent COVID-19 cases were identified in the country.
There was an agreement prior to this particular period. Mm-hmm. There was an agreement between the government of St. Kitts and the football associations of Guyana and I think Puerto Rico to allow the playing of the World Cup qualifiers here in St. Kitts in June. Mm-hmm. And so we do not want to disturb that agreement, and so those matches would be allowed to continue.
He said those matches will be controlled and the players will be tested before they arrive and after.
They're going to come in a bubble. They will be tested before they come. They will be tested when they reach. They will be tested during the period at regular intervals when they're here. They will be required to stay quarantined at a hotel, just among themselves. They will not be allowed to integrate with anyone else. And so they'll be sort of operating within a bubble. Mm-hmm. They'll be transported to the football stadium. They will not be allowed to come into contact with anybody outside of their bubble. They'll be taken back to the hotel after the games, and they could only mingle among themselves. They cannot mingle with anyone else outside of their bubble.
Superintendent Henry assured that they will be operating in a strict bubble and they will have to adhere to protocols applied to them before the matches can be played. He added spectators will not be allowed at any of these matches. In Trinidad and Tobago, cyclists hoping to make the national team and others eyeing gold at the Pan Am Games and Tokyo Olympics have begun preparing themselves. TTT News has more.
The first of 2 days of assessment for local cyclists desirous of making the national team for the upcoming Senior Pan Am Track Cycling Championships went as expected with some solid performances. Among those facing the starters in the Flying 200 is Nijian Philip of Rigtech Sonics. Like the others, he already achieved the qualifying standard, but the three-month window has passed, so the federation needed to test the rider's fitness once again, hence the latest round of sprints. He produced a 10.380 to lead the way. Also seeing action on day one was Karen Bramble with 10.529 and D'Angelo Harris, 11.121, all of whom are trying to make the team sprint unit to defend the title TNT1 in 2019. Quincy Alexander is expected to face the starters on Thursday evening as he too tries to dip under the qualifying standard. Olympic-bound sprinters Nicholas Paul and Kwesi Brown will join the team at the Games, which will serve as part of their build-up to Tokyo.
And that's it for sports. When we come back, we'll have another look at the stories that made the headlines.
The Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris, wants to alert the public about fake Facebook and social media accounts that are circulating. These sites may look genuine, but they're not. These fake sites may use the Prime Minister's photo and name, but their only intention is to spread misinformation through false and scandalous information. Some of these pages are scams and will attempt to dupe you out of money. Do not trust them. You can find the real Prime Minister Harris on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by searching for his official handle, which is at PMHarrisKN. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages that claim to be the Prime Minister's but do not have PMHarrisKN right after the forward slash are fake accounts. These should be reported to the respective social media sites. You can also report fake social media accounts to presssec@gov.kn. That's presssec@gov.kn. Facebook has verified Prime Minister Harris's official page by placing a white check mark inside a blue circle next to the Prime Minister's name, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris. This blue circle appears just above at PMHarrisKN. Also, be alert. If the person claiming to be either the Prime Minister or another government official asks you for money through instant messenger, direct message, or any other means, this is a scam and not a real charity. This public service announcement was produced in order to help you be an informed social media user. Protect yourself and help spread the message.
And wrapping up with a recap of the top stories. Chief Medical Officer says vaccine has high efficacy after 4 weeks. Attorney General responds to recent SCASPA announcement on use of facilities. And bus drivers express concern over new limited capacity. And that's the end of the Zelizer Channel 5 newscast. Thank you for joining us. I'm Calla Berridge.